In this video, we're going to talk about the text view. Let us start right now. Hi guys, my name is Agesh and I'm from 18bofficial.com. In this video, we're going to see about text view. So in order to implement any widget inside Android Studio, so there are actually two ways of doing it. One is we can write the XML code. So in order to do that, you need to go to the code session, which is right here. So if you are on the previous version of the Android Studios, I mean the older version, so the latest version is about 4.2, and you can find this exactly to the bottom of this screen, and you can see the text and design sessions, and go to the text session, and this is where we can implement the XML code. So if you are not aware of the XML code, go to the design tab and you can drag and drop the widget that you need. So in order to use the text view, go to the text option, which is right here. Let us drag the text view onto the screen, and now let us run our app and see how it will be on your real device. So if you don't know how to run your app, so watch my video on how to run our app onto your real device. The link will be in the description. So you can see I place the text view right here, but when I run the app, so it is moved to the this direction. So let me tell what exactly happened. So in this we are using this constraint layout, right? So in the constraint layout, we need to constraint every widget. So let me tell you what is a constraint. So in order to constraint this every widget, so you need to set the widget that you need to constraint, and you can see the four dots exactly to the border of the widget, and drag it to the respective directions, and then drag to the right. Now we will drag it to the left. Now if I run my app, so the text view will be exactly right here. The reason behind this we just constrained our widget to the left and to the right direction. So if you want to place the widget at the position that you need, so you need to constrain it to the four directions. Let me constrain it to the bottom and to the top as well. So now we will place this widget right here. So the reason behind this is we are implementing the splash screen of WhatsApp. So this is how it will be. So in this you can notice two text views, and one is from and other is this Facebook, and we are going to build this, and for that we are going to implement the text views of this splash screen, and in the next video we are going to implement the image view, and in the latter video we are going to see how to build a splash screen in Android Studio. So now let me run the app and see how it will be on a real device. Now we can see the position is exactly where we need. So this is how we need to place every widget inside the constraint layout. So we have different layouts like linear layout, and let us talk about these layouts in further videos. So let me stop my app now, and I'll close this emulator. So now the thing is, we need to change the text and improve the text height, and we need to change the color, right? So in order to do that, so select the text widget. So select the widget that we need to edit. So you can choose this attribute section. So these are the things that we can do with the text view. So the first thing is ID. So let us talk about ID in further videos. So now the first thing we need to do is declare the layout width and layout height. So select the widget, and these are the things that we need, that we can do with the text view, and you can see the widget name here. And so the first thing is the layout width and the layout height. So it is defaultly set to the wrap content. So the meaning of the wrap content means it exactly occupies the size of the content. Okay, let me show you this. Now the text size is about 14 sp. Let me change to 36. So now you can see the widget size is automatically improved. So this is due to we set this width to wrap content. Okay, let me set it to 20 dp. So this is how it will be in the 20 dp. So there is another option called match parent. So let us select the match parent. So the meaning of the watch parent means it entirely occupies the width. So in the layout width, we are selecting match parent, right? So now it will occupy the entire screen, width of the screen. If you select layout width also as match parent, let me show what will happen. So it will, the widget occupies the entire screen now. So now you can see it occupied the entire screen. And we normally go with wrap content every time. So that is the best thing. And let me change the text. So in order to change the text, you need to go to the session called common attribute session and change the text to from. And if you see the splash screen of WhatsApp, so this size will be somewhat low. So let me change to 18. And you can see the text is automatically reduced. The text size is reduced. So now the thing is, we need to implement another text view. And for this, so we need to place this exactly to the bottom of this first text view, right? So in order to do that, so let me constrain it to the left and right first. And so that the second text view should be to the bottom of the first text view, right? So let us constrain the bottom to the screen bottom, and we need to constrain the top of the second widget to the top of the, to the bottom of the widget that we need. So now it will be exactly to the bottom of the first widget. So if I change the first widget, and let me, so it is not constrained now. So first select the second widget and constrain it. So now if I change the first widget, so you can notice the second widget is also changing. So now let me change the second widget. Now it will not change, it will not affect the first widget. So this is how we need to do. And now we need to increase the text size of the second text view. And also we need to rename the text, right? So we need to rename as Facebook. And the next thing is, we need to improve the text size. So select this text size about to 36 SP. And we need to change the text color, right? So in order to do that, so you have an option called text color. So select on this, and you can, you will be, you can see this. And if you don't see this, you just need to copy this code. And let me select the green color. So somewhere it will be like this. So in next video, I will import the image, and up next we are going to implement the splash screen of WhatsApp. Thank you for watching. Please do comment and like, share, subscribe to 18B.